I've always sung. I sung as a little girl. I don't know why. I was shy, but I sang. And then I sang in choirs and triple trios. And then when I was 17, I discovered jazz. I heard my mother sang a lot of tunes around the house. I already knew this. I didn't know there was jazz standards. And then my cousin gave me three albums. He gave me Miles Davis, Ramsey Lewis, and Dave Brubeck. I had never heard jazz, and that was it. That was it. I joined a club to get a Columbia Records clubs, and I ticked off jazz, and I just started listening to everything I could. The rest is history. I just followed it. I remember it like it was yesterday. I kind of remember my first gig in New York. You know, was at a bar that I just convinced them to have music. But I sat in, as many singers are doing now, but they didn't have, they weren't like, you know, officially open mics, like now you sign in and sit in. I sat in all over the place. But it's interesting, I'm from Youngstown, Ohio, and it's, I always talk about this, there's no coincidences. And one of my best girlfriends in junior high married a jazz bass player. I mean, what are the chances of that? There wasn't that much jazz. And so I used to sit in with him at a restaurant, and he told me about a session. I mean, you know, so that was my first, like, actually singing for people, you know. And then when I graduated in college, there was a jazz trombonist who'd been out, and I sang for him, and boom, I was in his band. And then at 21, I came here to New York. Well, it encourages me, it inspires me to go on, even myself, into jazz. It's just so, there's so many young speak. You can't say jazz singing or jazz anything is dead, you know. But it keeps me on my toes because I have to practice what I preach. And I pretty much preach what I practice, you know. I mean, that's why I wrote my book, because it's like I'm just writing down what I do. But to see the growth, you know, the more you teach, the more you know what that singer should do next. So it keeps me going, you know. I've been doing it for so long, and maybe 15, 20 years ago, I thought I was going to teach until I started going on the road all the time, and then not, you know what I mean? It's sort of, and not that I didn't love it, but then a while back, I knew I'll never stop, no matter what, you know. I had two new releases, as you know. One is a duo with Jerry Grinnelli on drums. It's called Alone Together, and it came out in January. And one is brand new. It's coming out in September. And it's called Three for the Road with Ed Neumeister and Fritz Power, who died. He's a wonderful piano player in Austria, where I used to teach. And we do have a couple of gigs already. You have to have a deadline. It might be even just sitting in. I've been recommending Jocelyn's thing to some of my, even if, you know, to students now that are all over the place. It doesn't matter where they are now. And I say, why not? You know, it's not the same, but it's like, now, that's performance. Then you think you're going to do it, you're going to do it. But when you have a deadline, you do it. You know, right. You know you're going to sing, you plan the set. Right. But I always say plan the set even if you don't have a gig. I think if the gig comes because you planned the set. Hocus pocus.